Presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, what's new in ProPresenter 7.11? Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach you all about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, join the over 10,000 other people that have liked, subscribed, etc. to this channel. And that way you can get notifications when new tutorials are released. So, renewed vision, not sitting on their laurels, has just released a new version of ProPresenter. And so I thought that we would talk about all the new features that are available in ProPresenter 7.11. So let's head over to the computer. And here we are. You're actually looking at ProPresenter 7.11. So that's something for you to know. I'm going to be using this throughout this and the next couple of tutorials. So the first thing that you should know is we now have the ability to do an effect where we can change the transparency. Well, not transparency, more like a blur. We can also change the we can invert it. We can also change how saturated this is. So you'll notice that this part is less saturated from this part and a little more blurry, but notice that it is still a live video. So we have the ability to do that now in ProPresenter 7.11. We also have a brand new theme dialogue here, and we'll cover that in a future tutorial, along with the ability to attach background media to a theme, something that people have wanted to do for a long time. Some people have tried to do it. You could kind of do it with still images, but you couldn't really do it with motion images. Well, now you can. So with videos, they can be backgrounds to your themes in ProPresenter, and you can sometimes apply the background and sometimes not, and I'll show you how to do that in a future tutorial. Finally, we have Ventura support, mostly. So let me tell you what I mean by that. So if you have an Intel Mac, you can absolutely upgrade to Ventura. It's supported with ProPresenter 7.11, so once that's out of beta, or if you want to do some testing before you go and update, I'm going to update here in a few minutes myself, then you can use that. But if you have an Apple Silicon Mac, so either the M1 or M2 as of right now, and you use Resi, that is having problems right now. So if that's the situation for you, that you have Apple Silicon and you use Resi, do not update to Ventura just yet. Double check my thing. Yeah, don't update just yet. They're working on it. They're aware of the problem, but they wanted to get that out for the people that were either on Windows, works fine on Windows, on macOS Catalina or Mojave, for example, and on Intel or Apple Silicon and not using Resi, or those that are on Mojave and not using Resi, or that are using Resi. Any of those people would benefit. So the only problem is if you are on Apple Silicon with Ventura, don't update just yet. So that would be a bit of a problem. So keep that in mind, and in a future tutorial, I'll talk all about how to use each of these new features in ProPresenter 7.11. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course. So head on over to TDM.fyi/pro7 and quick. Give me your name and email address, and I will make a login for you for free. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.